And check, test, check, one. Hello, check, one, check. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, check, hello, check.
Bring these items.
Thank you. precious love lingered near when my life is all almost done. Hear my cry.
Paradise, and they will return to that homeland where there is no death, but only lasting joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear family and friends, when we celebrate a funeral, it is so natural for us to feel grief. But when we celebrate it in the assembly of those who believe in Jesus, it is a different experience. It is a different call to us. It is a call to us to recognize that Jesus stands by us in this life and the next. And in this faith, we have joy and we have thanksgiving for the life of Enid. She journeyed with Jesus. She suffered, as the gospel will illustrate so well in the last moments of Jesus. And we know now that he takes her to a life that is free from pain, free from suffering, and at the same time, a life that is caring for all of us, as she in the presence of the Lord will now join the saints and angels and all the souls whom we have known in our earthly journey and not known perhaps, in that one chorus of prayer for us on our earthly pilgrimage. With these sentiments, we enter the Eucharist of Jesus, the act of his death and resurrection, which is for us our hope, our joy, our promise. To prepare for celebrating these sacred mysteries, we acknowledge our limitations. We acknowledge our need for healing, for pardon, for growth. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. God of mercy, you are the hope of all peoples, and especially of sinners. You are the joy of saints. We pray for you. We pray for our sister Enid, whose body we honor with Christian burial. Give her happiness with your saints. Raise up her body in glory at the last day, to be in your presence forever and ever. Amen. We will now have the first reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 31 to 35, and 37 to 39. With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain, after such a gift, that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those what God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus? No. He not only died for us, he rose from the dead. And there at God's right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing, therefore, can come between us and the love of Christ. Even if we are troubled or worried, or being persecuted, or lacking food or clothes, or being threatened, or even attacked. These are the trials through which we triumph by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death nor life, no angel, no prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or height or depth, nor any created thing can ever come between us and the love of God, made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. For the responsorial psalm, we shall sing hymn number 388, The Lord is My Shepherd. Kindly join in singing.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my dream.
Alleluia, Alleluia. I have called you friends, says the Lord, because all I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. Alleluia.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
It was about the sixth hour, and with the sun eclipse, a darkness came over the whole land until the ninth hour. The veil of the temple was torn right down the middle. And when Jesus had cried out in a loud voice, he said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. With these words, he breathed his last. Then a member of the council arrived, an upright and virtuous man, Joseph. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. He then took it down, wrapped it in a shroud, and put him in a tomb which was hewn in stone, in which no one had been laid yet. And on the first day of the week, at the first sign of dawn, the women went to the tomb with the spice they had prepared. They found that the stone had been rolled away from the tomb, but on entering discovered that the body of the Lord Jesus was not there. And as they stood there, not knowing what to think, two men in brilliant clothes suddenly appeared at their side. Terrified, the women lowered their eyes. But the two men said to them, "Why look among the dead for someone who is alive? He is not here, he has risen." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, if the reading of today makes little impact on our lives, then funerals will be tragic. But if we can place our faith in this gospel, in what it describes to us, then a funeral is the herald of the resurrection. They saw it all, the disciples of Jesus. They saw him hang, bleeding to death. They saw him defeated in life. And they wondered whether there was any future to such a leader of their cause. As with us too, we have doubts about life very often, whether life can open up to anything better than tragedy. Our sorrows, our failures, our sins can all be blocks into this awareness of what life can be with Jesus. And the gospel goes on. It describes simple women who had perhaps stood near the cross and seen Jesus defeated, isolated, marginalized, ridiculed. They still wanted to do something for him. And they go to the tomb with spices and they want to clean him up and anoint him, the last gesture of love that they could offer to him who they valued so much. Again, the parallel is with the life of Enid, who died with a considerable amount of suffering. No doctors could reveal it, could repeal that suffering. We of the family too felt a lot of helplessness. And so she breathed her last, as Jesus did on his cross. And then now, in this funeral celebration, we are doing what those women wanted to do for Jesus. We are coming together in order to give Enid a good burial. But as we are engaged in this act, we recall what the women experienced in their efforts to give Jesus the best of what they had. The encounter with the voice of heaven, telling them, no, this is not the end. He is not here. He has gone before. He has risen. And every funeral has these movements. Whether one says goodbye to the person as the person breathes his or her last, whether that person is in agony like Jesus was in his last moments, or in a very peaceful way breathes her or his last breath, all these movements are parallel in the gospel. And if we have the sensitivity to read the gospel, knowing that God is communicating through that gospel something that we take for our own lives, we will come to the same experiences as the early followers of Jesus when they came to the tomb and found the body missing. What will we find today as we celebrate this funeral of Enid? We will find that her life is still alive in us, that her witness is still alive in us, that what she tried to do with the values she had is still very precious to our lives today. Just as the early church and the early disciples kept recalling what Jesus was saying, what Jesus had said to them while he moved about with them, all that he taught them, all that he exhorted them to do, to be, came back to them. And when the period of grief gave way to the period of realizing that in Jesus we all live, we never die, in that realization they began to live their Christian mission. May we too today give this pledge to Enid, that we will not allow our grief to obscure what she stood for as a Christian, as a mother, as someone who suffered in bed but never named God in any derogatory way. Her faith was alive. And if you see that little video that one of you managed to get in her declining days, you will see her bless. You will see her bless and not fuss about herself. You will see her bless her children, her grandchildren, and everyone through them, blessing them with her vision of her faith. That is, may all of us live blessed lives. May all of us take our sufferings and sorrows with courage and with faith and endurance, because the Lord Jesus, the risen one, accompanies us. She is not here, she is risen. The angels tell this to us again and again. May we have the courage to believe their message and live our lives faithful to the call of Jesus. Amen. We will now have the prayers of intercession. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for my grandma. In baptism, she lived and died with Christ. May she now share fully in his resurrection. We pray to the Lord. Your response.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of consolation, help us to comfort one another in our grief. We pray for all those who have gone before us. Lord, give them the reward of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who care for the sick, the aged, and those who require our special support, especially those who cared for my grandma during her final days. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those here today and those who cannot be present, that the memory of my grandma, who we loved, may inspire us with a renewed energy to love and serve our brothers and sisters. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the lessons of teaching, faith, and affection that my grandma demonstrated and lived by during her life be a source of inspiration to us all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we offer our prayers and petitions to you in faith that you answer us, in faith that ENID will journey to you and pray for us. We thank you for this opportunity to recall the foundations of our faith and to live by it as sincerely as ENID tried to do. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. For the offertory hymn, kindly take hymn number 311, On the Pattern.
Our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Lord, accept this sacrifice we offer for our sister ENID on the day of her burial. May your love cleanse her from her human weaknesses and forgive any sins she may have committed. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do will always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. He chose to die that he might free all peoples from dying. He gave his life that we may live to you alone forever. In our joy, we sing to your glory with all the choirs of angels as we say.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim this mystery of faith. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, and all your saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from all useless worry, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We offer each other a sign of peace. Peace, peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is Jesus who promises us eternal life. Happy are we who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Lord, help me believe in what I could be and the more that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me today, one day at a time. One day at a time. Sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a among men. Well, Jesus, you know, if you look in below, it's worse now than then. Cheating and stealing, violence and crime. Lord, for my sake, teach me today, one day at a time. One day at a time. Sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. Anyone who lives and believes in me will not die. Hallelujah.
Thanksgiving prayer. Mummy, through self-sacrifice, and a tremendous amount of love for us all, you gave us a real chance at a good life. You provided and sustained us with more than what we needed. We thank you and we pray that God, our Heavenly Father, now grant you a place in his heavenly abode alongside Daddy for a well-deserved eternal rest. Just a few thank yous for people who have been part of Mummy's life in the past few years and those who have helped with this beautiful service. First of all, Celia, Savio and Joshua, who have been Mummy's rock and strength all these years. We are eternally grateful to you. To the carers who have shown great dedication to look after Mummy's needs 24/7. To Ronnie and others who brought communion to Mummy. To all of Mummy's building friends who have been her social mainstay in Malad, as well as her family and friends over the years. To Godfrey, thank you for dashing down all the way from Nandurbar and making yourself available to celebrate this special service for Mummy. Thank you, Father Antonio, for allowing us to celebrate this service at St. Teresa's at such short notice. A huge big hug and thank you to Claire for helping us to organize the service at St. Teresa's. We couldn't have done this without you, Claire. And to our wonderful choir, Penny, Bernice, Philip, Frankie, Celeste, Charmaine, thank you for making yourselves available as well at such short notice. Thank you, Karen and Michelle, for your help today. Truly appreciated. And to all of you present here today, and to the many people who have sent us such wonderful messages of condolences, your presence and your messages are very appreciated. Francis, what is it, a few words?
मला मराठी मध्ये दोन शब्द बोलायचं. तुम्ही बाया ज्यांनी इनची काळजी घेतली आणि त्याच्या शेवटच्या क्षणी तुम्ही जवळ होतं, तुम्हाला एक विशेष आभार आम्ही मानतो. या सर्व प्रार्थनामध्ये आम्ही इंग्लिशमध्ये बोलली, पण त्या प्रार्थनाचं एकच अर्थ होतं की आमचा विश्वास आहे येशूवर आणि इनिट बाई येशूच्या स्वर्ग राज्यात प्रवेश करणार अशी आमची प्रार्थना होती. तुम्ही रात्रंदिवस त्यांची काळजी घेतली, याबद्दल आम्ही तुझे फार आभार मानतो. आणि हे सोपं नाही अशा माणसांची काळजी घ्यायला. सो हे आम्ही मुद्दामच मराठीमध्ये सांगितलं, कारण तुम्हाला कदाचित समजणार नाही इंग्लिशमध्ये कोणाचं नाव घेतलंय. Let us pray. Father, all-powerful God, we pray for our sister Enid, whom you have called from this world. May this Eucharist cleanse her, forgive her sins, and raise her to eternal joy in your presence. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. There will be now expressions of thanks and on this occasion by Francis and other members of the family.
Along with my siblings Nirmala, Clarence, Colin, Richard, Grace and Celia and our families, I'd like to thank you all for joining us today to acknowledge and celebrate the life of my mother Enid. I could spend the next couple of hours talking about what Mummy meant to us, but she'd be embarrassed and, knowing her, would suggest that I find something better to do with my time. And in many ways, that sums her up. A no-nonsense person when work was to be done, totally devoted to her family, never asking for anything nor expecting any favors, but at the same time, always able to find time to help us to grow and to develop. Even at her most pragmatic, she showed her sense of fun and creativity. Her recipes, for example, were modified to feed what must have felt like 500, but they never stinted on flavor, which is something very obvious in our waistlines. Mummy also loved a good pun. She liked to sing, and she delighted her family with handmade cards on birthdays and Christmases. She ran the house in a way that would be the envy of many corporate operations managers and financial controllers. She made multitasking look easy. A typical day involved teaching, giving tuitions, preparing for class, or marking papers, cooking, organizing sandwiches and lunch for 7 school-going children, and a host of other tasks. She made us all feel very proud when, despite the multiple roles she had to play, she was able to secure a first class in her B.Ed. course at an advanced age. Our memories, however, will be particularly for Mummy as a kind comforter, always able to find time to listen to our problems, however small. A self-sacrificer, she always put others first and was always willing to make the big sacrifices herself. An explorer, she opened our minds to the world of books. Both Mummy and Daddy read stories and stimulated our imaginations through such wonderful characters as the famous Five, Jeeves and Wooster, and Poirot. She had an uncanny ability to quote poems, songs, and verses from memory, appropriate to any occasion, from Yere Yere Pausa, when it was raining, to new shoes, red and pink and blue shoes, when we bought a new pair of shoes. I have to confess, though, that I was quite startled when she encouraged me as a young boy to read a Mills and Boons book so that I, and I quote, "You at least know what the books are like, and then if you decide not to read them, it's okay." As an educator, now the best educators teach more than their subject. The best history teacher I have had, calm, always a smile on her face, gentle, encouraging, and patient, are some of the numerous tributes that we have received from so many of her grateful students from Fort Convent and beyond. Mummy valued and remembered most of her students long after they left school, and these tributes are a fitting testimony to the impact she made on their lives and minds. She told us to never settle for mediocrity. As a believer in us, always encouraging us not to be afraid of trying out new things. A person of strong faith, in which she found great comfort right to the very end. A fighter, overcoming adversity throughout her life, starting from having to give up her job as a teacher just because she decided to get married. Many health issues, the challenges of bringing up 7 children, the list is endless. In each of the cases, she demonstrated a quiet strength that taught us how to face adversity and deal with it. As an encourager, she gave us the backbone, support, and caring not to be scared to fail. She instilled in us her values, dreams, understanding of the way life is, and most importantly, should be. Mummy hated troubling anyone else for things she needed right up to the end. She was lucky, of course, to have Celia, Savio, and Joshua by her side, and we thank them for their dedication in looking after her. She had tremendous willpower and sometimes was almost stubborn in the wanting to help herself. Mummy's life was a life of service, and she now transitions to a life of peace and joy with Daddy and her parents and brother and sister. Thank you, Mummy, for your dedication to our family. We are proud to have had you as our mother. May you now find the peace and happiness that you so richly deserve. And I promise, I'll finally learn to hang the towel on the rack the way you like it. I'd like to now invite Leyland Mendes, Mummy's godchild, and also sharing the same birth date as her.
Thanks, Francis, for that. This is beautiful. We have come to bid farewell to Auntie Enid, who also happens to be my godmother as well. Auntie Enid was a few words, quiet and reserved. But when she spoke, one could sense a certain tone which could uplift you. I gather she was quite strict in school as a teacher, but to me, she was an aunt. When my father took ill in 1984 and 85, she and her family, my cousins, Uncle Leslie and all, assisted in the hospital as we were very young. I and my siblings will always remember that. Being a teacher, I remember she and Uncle Leslie, her late husband, gifted me a Tell Me Why book for my first Holy Communion, which made me interested in reading. Her knowledge of the English language is what she and her brothers were interested in, and their conversations were interesting to hear. Come Christmas, and we would wait to get her sweets, especially her milk cream. I see a couple of recipes of milk cream handwritten, which has in brackets ENIDs/Auntie ENIDs. We shared the same birthday, that is December 27th, and when young, on my return from hearing Mass, a stop by to wish Auntie Enid meant getting a little bit more milk cream and some cake. Not to mention a sum of money with a few words saying, "This is for you." In the last 30 years, she lost her sister, Auntie Gerlu, first, and then her husband, Uncle Leslie. Loss of Uncle Leslie did leave a void, but she carried on. We used to meet at family functions later on, and the tone in her voice will always be remembered by me. It had a sort of springy tone. As one gets engrossed in one's life with one's own family and work, one tends to lose regular touch with one's family. I did exchange greetings on festivals and birthdays, and it was good to hear her voice. She, among her sister and brothers, to me, was the calmest. Many a time I have seen my father being told by her to relax and see things in perspective. I remember telling my dad, her brother, there was no need to risk one's life during COVID to shut up our Gorai house for the monsoon. As Dad was worried, what would happen to the house, which has stood for about 120 years, if the balconies were not covered up? He did see reason and mentioned that Auntie Enid said, "Forget it." The teacher was called by the principal a few days ago, Jesus Christ, and the headmistress, Mother Mary, to eternal rest with her beloved Leslie and her family. Auntie Enid, you were a good teacher, counselor. May Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, along with our Blessed Mother, look after you hereon. Amen.
Thank you, Leland. I'd like to invite Karen, my cousin now, and my mom's niece, who spent a bit of time with her towards the end.
Bidding farewell is always tough. Words never prove to be enough. Saying goodbye is never simple. To a teacher, aunt like you is special. Our dearest Aunt Enid was not only a teacher, but a second mom to us. We were a close-knit family and always spent our May and October holidays with our cousins, parents, aunts, uncles, and grandparents at Gorai in our ancestral home. We thoroughly enjoyed each other's company, and we cousins got very close to each other during these times. We looked forward to meeting each other at the Bandra and Girgaum feasts, which were celebrated with zest and enthusiasm. Aunt Enid was very famous for her bakes and pies and shared so many recipes with me when I got married. It was 28 years ago when I was married, barely a year after which I lost my mom. And it was at this time that Aunt Enid became our second mom. It was a shock to the entire family, not only to us, but to mom's sister and brothers. A few years later, Auntie Enid lost her husband, Uncle Leslie, on his birthday while holidaying in Muscat at his daughter Nimu's home. This was even a greater shock to the entire family, And Aunt Enid lived alone for so many years as her six children migrated overseas. And she thereafter chose to move close to her youngest daughter, Celia, who has been her rock and support all these years. Aunt Enid was a dedicated teacher and taught English and history at Fort Convent. Last year, when we lost our priest, Uncle Father Kenny, it took a setback on Auntie Enid, as she would call him daily and talk to him over various current day happenings. Auntie Enid had a fall just during COVID, but never recovered fully after that. She hated to be lying in bed and dependent on others. But as time flew by and the world was affected by COVID-19, Auntie Enid bravely lived through this for close to 90 long years. Her memory never failed, and this was evident in our last conversation I had with her on the 16th of September, a few days before her death, and she remembered everyone's names and always inquired about each one and their families. We will miss you, Auntie Enid. Our deepest condolences to our cousins, Nirmala, Francis, Clarence, Colin, Richard, Grace, Celia, and their families, and Uncle Vivi and his family, and the extended family, sisters Hazel, Shirley, and Father Godfrey. Those special memories of you will always bring a smile. You always meant so very much and always will do too. The fact that you are no longer here will always cause a pain, but you're forever in our hearts until we meet again. Rest in peace, dearest Auntie Enid. We love you.
We will now have the final blessing of this Eucharistic celebration. Please stand. Heavenly Father, as we have given thanks to you for Enid, and most of all for the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, which sustains us and sustains her, recalling all the blessings to our lives from her earthly existence, we now ask for your heavenly blessing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will now have the blessing of the coffin. Or will you all sing the last hymn first? We'll have the blessing. With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our sister Enid to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give her a merciful judgment and forgive all her sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead her safely home
to be at peace with God our Father. And may she be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Saints of God, come to her aid. Come to meet her, angels of the Lord. Our response, receive her soul after me and present her to God the Most High. May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Our response, after me, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Give her eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on her forever. Receive her soul and present her Most High. Father, into your hands we commend our sister Enid. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, she will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave her in this life to show your care for us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our sister to paradise. Help us support and comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ, to be with you and with our sister Enid forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May the angels lead you into paradise and the martyrs and saints welcome you, take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Amen.
Before we have the final hymn, a couple of things. One is for those who would like to come along with us to Sewri for the burial. We've got a bus and it's on the left, as you get out of the church, on the left side. You're more than welcome to avail that service. And for those who are participating in the service through the online streaming, we will be streaming the burial service also. There'll be a break, of course, while we move to Sewri, and we expect to be back around midday, but just keep an eye on YouTube for that. Thank you.
May the good Lord bless us. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, let us pray for our sister Enid, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even if she dies. And every living person who puts her faith in me will never suffer eternal death. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you sorrowed at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear our prayer. You raised the dead to life. Give our sister eternal life. We ask this in faith. Lord, you promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith. Our sister was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith. Now together let us say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, we pray together to our Lady, Hail Mary. Lord, listen to our prayer for our sister. And as she always desired to do your will, so in your mercy forgive whatever wrong she may have done. By her Christian faith, she is united with all your believing people. Now, in love and mercy, give her a place with your angels and saints. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Give her eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on her forever. Now together,
played by T.F. Carr.
I have to you, my dear. Now I am grown and I can walk straight all on my own. I'd like to give you what you gave to me, mother, sweet mother.
All our sins and griefs to bear.